the nature of the statement.
I can only
you know, discern that, you know, from the circumstantial evidence, you know, of what I see. Okay? What I certainly see is that, you know, HH is gunning for ECL. No doubt.
Okay?
I mean, he can't wait to get a team. Okay? He can make any statement, you know, that, no, I'm not after, you know, Edgar Lungu, you know. His officials can say, no, no. Is not after, you know, the truth of the matter is that the man is traveling at the high speed on this road of vengeance against Edgar Lungu. ECL locked him up at Mukobeko for a silly offense which he himself committed in Mongo. Okay? For a silly offense which he committed to excite people, to show people in Mongo that he was very popular. And he wanted, you know, to block the presidential motorcade. And I said it, you know, on many programs, you know, that if it were...
Watch the entire video, my lovely viewers, I mean from start to finish, to get the whole thing. Without wasting much of your time, let's get right into it. Hi lovely viewers, it's me again, your one and only Mtati Mpundu. Welcome to my YouTube channel. If this is your first time on my channel, kindly subscribe to my YouTube channel by hitting the red subscribe button down below and turn the bell icon to join the notification squad. Don't forget to like, share and leave a comment. Tell me what you think about this video in the comment section below. I'll be super glad to hear from you lovely viewers.
We get to something also that raised a bit of talk and one of the issues now that people are thinking, I don't know if this was just, according to the people that are in government today, that was just a stance to win public sympathy, according to them. The briefing that was held by the children to the former president with regards to the treatment they've, been given since President Edgar Chagwalungu, former president, of course, left power. They cried foul that the state is... trying them in the general, or should I say on the media, as opposed to court, and they want to be taken to court to answer to allegations that are being labeled against them before the public.
Yes, I think the issue there is this. Firstly, the constitution the constitution of the Republic of Zambia guarantees you and I the right to private property. You have a right to own property in this country under the Zambian constitution. Okay? And that property cannot be taken away from you without the due process of law. Second point. I think the point that the Lungus were making was this short-circuiting of that process by the DPP. If you recall, that press conference came on the heels of the DPP saying that he had made an application to court without trying, you know, those that owned the property, and he wanted this property forfeited to the state. Now, if you suspect me to be in possession of property that is suspected to be proceeds of crime. Under the Zambian constitution, like I said earlier, I enjoy the right of the presumption of innocence. That I'm innocent until I'm proven guilty. So the way you do it is take me to court. Prosecute me. And the way you do it is take a statement from me. I don't have to read about your steps in the media. Of course, we are in a democracy. It is always good that the public knows what is happening to every citizen. But you don't do it in reverse. If you remember, when the DPP took those steps, the lawyer, Makhembe Zulu, issued a statement. He said, how can you go to the press before you even save any process, any court documents on us as lawyers, or even on the so-called court accused? Okay? So I think there is a bit of excitement also within the DPP's office and the anti-corruption office, you know, over these matters, and that's how they are, and that's why they are messing themselves up. That's why we can't see the expected results in this fight against corruption, because right among us, you know, I mean, I worked myself, Eugene, you know, in local government. You know, I remember in the 1981 Shamwana coup, the late Joshua Simuzia was DPP. I never heard or saw DPP Joshua Simuzia go and hold a press conference that we have arrested Edward Shamwana, we are prosecuting, you know, Edward Shamwana, because he wanted to overthrow the government. And there are many DPPs that came, you know, after that. Joshua Simuzia, you know, Gregory Piri, a retired judge now. I never saw them in the press. This excitement that we are seeing now from these small boys, every day they want to be in the press. Every day they want to be in the press. Oh my God, that's not how that job is done. Can you give reverence, you know, to that office? Okay? So I think the Lungus have a right to cry foul. That if you are going to try them in the court of public opinion, then it means you don't have a case against them. If you have a case against them, you do it quietly. You take them, you know, before, you know, a tribunal established by law, meaning a court of law. Go and produce the evidence. And then, away from the DPP's press statements, let the magistrate, you know, make a decision. If they are aggrieved by that decision by the magistrate, you know that they got the right to go to the High Court. If they are aggrieved by the decision of the High Court, you know that they've got the right to go to the court of to the Court of Appeal. If they are still not satisfied with the judgment of the Court of Appeal, you know that they've got the right to go to the Supreme Court. So why does the DPP want to make himself the Alpha and the Omega in the criminal justice system? I think that is wrong.
Let's get to some of the sentiments that were also made. I remember, the member of the Patriotic Front, who is also in the race to becoming, in the race to the presidency of the Patriotic Front, Mr. Brian Mundubile. After that particular, you know, briefing from the Lungus there, he issued a statement to say that the UPND, the way they are conducting themselves towards the former president, is like his immunity was lifted already. Can we say that there's a bit of truth in that statement there? With the regards, or maybe the question should be, how is the treatment, towards the former president? Is it sour when it comes to the current president and the former president?
I don't know. I don't want to speculate. I don't know about, the nature of the statement. I can only descend that, you know, from the circumstantial evidence, you know, of what I see. Okay? What I certainly see is that, you know, HH is gunning for ECL. No doubt.
Okay?
I mean, he can't wait to get at him. Okay? He can make any statement, you know, that, no, I'm not after, you know, Edgar Lungu. You know, his officials can say, no, is not after, you know, the truth of the matter is that the man is traveling at the high speed on this road of vengeance against Edgar Lungu. ECL locked him up at Mukobeko for a silly offense which he himself committed in Mongo. Okay? For a silly offense which he committed to excite people, to show people in Mongo that he was very popular. And he wanted, you know, to block the presidential motorcade. And I said it, you know, on many programs, you know, that if it were in other countries, HH would have been shot, dead that day by the security people, because he was risking the life of a head of state. So he does something silly himself, and now he turns around to be vengeful against the action that was taken against him. The difference, you know, that the position that I took at that time was that what he did was not reasonable.
All
right. Okay? And I made that statement when ECL was still in office. I said, yes, what has happened is silly, but this is not treason. I still went ahead to pay him a visit, you know, in prison. Not because he hadn't done something wrong, but because he was a colleague in the opposition. So there's no doubt that the man is still bitter from that experience. So all this thing about, you know, the Lungus is targeted at ECL at the end of the day. So he has to harass his children, he has to harass his wife, you know, and stress the man and that kind of thing, you know. But you see, what is really saddening is that HH has more important problems on his hands than ECL. He has more important things. The people here in the Chipata compound are going hungry. They don't care about ECL. As far as they are concerned, he's already out of power. What they want is for him to deal with issues of their bread and butter. This morning, there's a contingent of police officers on the streets in town to throw out the street vendors. Those street vendors are not the problem. They are a symptom of a collapsed economy, an economy which he promised to come and fix. They are doing that because they want jobs from him, and he promised them jobs. So my view is that he has much more important things that should be keeping him awake at night, and not ECL. Even assuming that he locked up ECL tomorrow, how will that improve the Kwacha dollar rate? How will that feed the people of Chawama? How will that reduce the price of fuel in this country? How in God's name would the locking up of ECL just turn around this economy overnight? So if he wants to listen to an independent piece of advice, it's Bwana. If ECL has done something wrong, the law will catch up with him. And you are not the police officer. Leave that to the police. In the meantime, get on with the business that the Zambian people voted you for.
This is DJ Mutati exclusive.
Savage. Alright, that's all right for you today, lovely viewers. If you did enjoy the video, please don't forget to leave a comment in the comment section below. Tell me what you think about the video you just watched in the comment section below. I'll be super glad to hear from you, lovely viewers. Once again, I go by the name of Mutati Mpundu. I love you, peace. I gotta go.